I cannot believe what I'm going to share with you today. Oh, I should have had Kleenex. Why am I always sharing my raw emotions? Why is this always navigating my own identity? Why am I constantly questioning my decisions or the spirit? I have something personal and vulnerable I want to share with you today. It's about why I find myself always so vulnerable when sharing my raw emotions. I can't believe I'm gonna share this today, but I believe that it's important to open up and discuss these experiences. A few years back, I had a close friend whom I met on Facebook. We connected a year and a half after I was baptized into the Church of Jesus Christ. She had been a member for 10 years. Our friendship was strong until one day when we had a significant disagreement. She told me that the church was just using me as their gay poster child when I defended Elder Holland in August 2021 when he spoke at his speech at BYU. We had started a podcast together, bringing together four people from different parts of the world with different perspectives about the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. However, later I discovered that she had blocked me on all social media sites and was posting anti-church content. I was shocked and hurt by this sudden turn of events. Recently, during my visit to the temple, I felt a strong prompting to put her name on the prayer roll. It was a significant moment for me. And then, just today, a YouTube video showed up as a suggested view. To my surprise, it was a video where she was talking about returning to the church for the first time in a year. I was excited to see this and felt it was a positive sign. After much prayer and fasting, I decided to call her. I wanted to let her know that I had been praying for her. However, her response caught me off guard. She said, "Is this a joke? You praying for someone who is not a member of your church is practicing witchcraft." She told me to go back to bed and hung up. I can't help but feel confused, hurt, or even doubtful about myself after that conversation. It's difficult to understand how things have turned out this way. But through this experience, I've learned some valuable lessons. One important lesson is the power of vulnerability and the importance of sharing raw emotions. It's not always easy, but it allows us to connect on a deeper level and create meaningful connections. I've also realized that relationships can be complex and people can change in unexpected ways. It's essential to approach these situations with understanding and compassion. Later, when I looked at the description of the video, I clicked on the three buttons in the upper left-hand corner and noticed that this video was posted May 2nd, 2021. I've learned such a valuable lesson from this. We need to take it to God. We need to ask God, for what do I need to learn from this experience? Not why me. That's what this is all about. This hasn't been easy because, especially during COVID, I would call her every night. She lives on the West Coast. There's a 3-hour time difference. And we would spend hours and hours talking. However, there were several warning signs that she did that I want to bring you aware of. One of them is, she took away my unrighteous dominion. Do you know what that means? She told me several times that she had feelings that we were going to be married. And she made me question my core. She made me question. She said, if you and I are married, which I had prophecy and revelation on, we could be sealed together for eternity. Now, at the time, she was considered bisexual. Now she considers herself a lesbian. And she considers herself a content creator or influencer. I don't know how many, I know she became big on TikTok, but she wasn't that on Instagram or YouTube. But she still thought in her mind she was big. And that's the problem. When people let it go to their head that they have become something that they're not, i.e., saying I had revelation or prophecy that you and I are going to be married, that's taking away someone's unrighteous dominion. It's not good. It would be like if I said to you, oh, I went to the temple, my friend, and sister, I had revelation that we're going to be married and sealed for eternity in the temple. You can't do that. That is taking away somebody's judgment. And that's what she did. Another thing she did was she performed paganism, Satanism, and did a ritual where she had two candles burning. She had a rope between the two of them. And she said when the candles burn down and that rope breaks, her tie to the church breaks. That's wrong. That's false prophecy. We don't believe in anything. Nothing is secret, what we do. It's sacred. It's sacred. It's personal covenants that we make with Heavenly Father. There's nothing secret about it. All found in Scripture, in the Bible. Everything we do is listed in here. So if you think that we're not Christian, or if you call us a cult, you don't know the definition of an occult. An occult doesn't allow you to leave. Our doors are open. You want to leave? There's the driveway. There's the pavement. End of story. You can choose to have agency to leave anytime you want. That's your decision, not mine. Not your neighbor's, not anyone else's. That is your decision. So don't take away my unrighteous dominion. Don't. I didn't even know what that word meant until she introduced it to me. Until she, because every night I would call her, she would read scripture to me. She would study the Come Follow Me curriculum. And at the time, we were in Doctrine and Covenants. And she read me the entire Doctrine and Covenants scripture from front to back. We need to keep these people in our prayers and know that they have agency. Agency to choose between CTR, choose the right, or choose to remember him, or current temple recommend holder. urge you to reflect on your own experiences and share your thoughts and stories. Together, we can grow and support each other, just like our Savior, Jesus Christ. I want to emphasize the importance of self-care and the importance of these challenging times. Taking care of ourselves emotionally, mentally, and spiritually is crucial. It's okay to feel hurt and confused, but we must also remember to give ourselves the love and accept we need. In conclusion, I want to thank you for allowing me to share this personal journey with you. It's not easy to discuss these vulnerable moments, but I believe it's important to foster understanding and create a space for open dialogue. I need to close with my testimony. As everyone may not understand us or our beliefs, whether we read the Holy Bible or the Book of Mormon or Doctrine and Covenants, I know that I joined this church without reservation after many years of being an anti-member, after many years of not believing that the gospel of Jesus Christ was for me. Because I read everything on Google, I became a Googleologist. I know that people may not see us as being equal or the same as them, but that needs to tell us that we are in the true church. And I know, like what is said in James 1:5, any of us lack wisdom, we need to ask of God, not Google, not YouTube. Go to the source or go to an official website of the church, not myself or not a blog or not, you know, bring it to God, James 1:5. And I know that as we all strive to be fellow brothers and sisters within the gospel of Jesus Christ, that we are going to encounter challenges. But together, as we develop our testimony in our Savior, not in man, that we will grow stronger as we strive to meet our Maker. And I say that as my testimony, humbly, in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.